And the way to do this, he maintains, is to consider language in its natural setting to see all the circumstances in which people say things, the behaviour that characteristically accompanies their saying certain things.
Can I now bring you back to the question of what the influence of this philosophy has been, especially outside philosophy?
I fail to take up that question, you're quite right.